Welcome to all the students, all of my dear students. That is, in the previous class, I have discussed about the main type of sexual reproduction. That is, one is the synergy, another is the conjugation, and another is the parthenogenesis. I have told you that in case of the synergy, the male gamete and the female gametes are permanently and completely fusing to form the zygotes. And in case of the conjugation, here the parent body behaving as the gametes and they are fusing temporarily, and after some time they are separating and behaving, and they are called as the exconjugant. And in case of the parthenogenesis, Parthenos means, I have told you, this is in case, that is a Greek word, that is Partheno means, that is the virgin, and genesis means origin. That means a female, that is in case of, that is in Oria, it is called as the Sati. That is the girl is producing the child without the, that is the marriage. That means the egg is developing into a child or into an offspring without the fertilization, that is called as the offspring, which is mainly found in case of the insects, that is honeybees, etc. Then you come to the, that is the next, that is the class, that is called as the human reproduction. This is the main and the important portion of the reproduction, and it is called as, or it is named as the human reproduction. The in case of the human beings, the reproduction occurs totally by the sexual process. No, that is asexual. That is, here it is totally occurring by the asexual process, and which involves the major events like the gametogenesis, It is the first phase of the sexual reproduction by which the gametes are forming in the gonads. That is by the process of gametogenesis. That is by the process of gametogenesis, the gametes are formed inside the gonads. This is the first phase of the sexual type of reproduction, how the gametes are produced. And the second one is called as the insemination. Insemination or copulation. That is, the second is called as the insemination, or that is the copulation. The process by which the sperm or the semen are or is discharged into the, that is the reproductive tract of the female, is called as the insemination, or it occurs through the copulation, or it which occurs through the copulation. That is called as the insemination. And the third was is called as the fertilization. The third event is called as the fertilization. The process by, or it is a process by which the male gamete fuses, or that the combines with the female gamete to form the zygote. It is called as the fertilization. Then this fourth one is called as the cleavage. That is, the cleavage is nothing but a process of repeated mitotic type of cell division in the zygote to convert it into blastula. And in case of the human beings, it is called as the blastocyst. That blastula is called as the blastocyst. In human beings, the blastula is called as the blastocyst. So the cleavage is a process of repeated mitotic division of the zygote to convert into the blastocyst is called as the cleavage. Then the fifth one, the fifth phase, is called as the implantation. That is implantation. The implantation is a process where the blastocyst attaches with the uterus of the female. That is called as the implantation. since the human beings or all the mammals are, that is the viviparas, so by the formation, they get the nourishment by the formation of the placenta. So that is called as the implantation, that is the attachment of a blastocyst into the uterine wall of the female is called as the implantation. Then you, that is called as the gestation. That is the sixth one. The sixth one is called as the gestation. Gestation means it is the time taken by the individual for its full growth, that is the pregnancy period or gestation period. It is about, that is 280 days, where that is the gestulation takes place and organogenesis takes place. Gestulation means that is the blastula or the blastocyst is a single layer embryo, and in through the gestulation it converts into three layer, that is embryo. First one is ectoderm, second one is mesoderm, third one and inner one is called as the endoderm. Then the next step is called as the organogenesis. Organogenesis means the, that is the three layer, that is the embryo converts, or these germ layers converting into different organs, that is heart, liver, etc. The formation of heart, liver, etc. That is called as the, that is the, that is the, the, that is called as the organogenesis. And under the gestation involves, or gestation consists of, that is the gestulation and that is the organogenesis. Then the another is called as the parturition, that is called as the parturition. Parturition means that is the delivery, or that is the childbirth, that is called as the childbirth, or that is the parturition means the childbirth, the process by which that is the child comes from or comes out from the uterus to the outside, that is called as the parturition, or it is called as the, in that is the brief sense, it is called as the delivery. Then another is called as the lactation. Lactation is another phase of the sexual reproduction. The lactation, in this process, the, that is the milk is produced inside the mammary gland, and which helps for the nourishment of the child, but the young ones. So these are the process which will, that is discussed, that is one by one in a lateral case. The first one, that is the gametogenesis. In, under the gametogenesis, the gametes are produced, and the second one is called as the insemination. In this insemination, that is the semen, that is are discharged, is discharged into the, that is the reproductive tract of the female. And the third is the fertilization, the process by which the male gamete fuses with the female gamete to form the zygote. Then the third one is called as the cleavage. That fourth one is called as the cleavage, by which that is the, that is the repeated mitotic division occurs in the zygote, which converts into a unicellular, or that is the structure into a multicellular single layered blastula or blastocyst in case of the male. Then you come to the, that is the implantation. That is the implantation is a process by which that is the blastocyst attaches into the uterine wall of the female. Then another is called as the gestation, and the gestation is, that is the gestation is, or the gestation period in case of the human beings, it is about 280 days. In this gestation, the, it is the growth phase, or the, that during which that is the zygote develops into a full structure embryo, and that includes, that is the gestulation, where three germ layers are formed, then organogenesis, different organs are formed. Then that is, you come to the parturition. Parturition is the process by which the full formed embryo or full formed child comes to the outside from the mother's uterus. It is called as the parturition. Then the lactation. After the, that is parturition, the child birth, that is the milk is produced, or milk is synthesized inside the mammary gland, and it helps for the nourishment of the child. It is called as the, it is called as the lactation. Then that is the, in case of the human beings, that is human beings are unisexual. That means the male and the females are separate. They are called, that is the unisexual. That is called as the unisexual. Or that is generally in sexual reproduction, the biparental or the biparent is, or there are two individuals that is necessary. One is one male, another is female. Then the male having different organs to perform the reproduction, as well as the female has different organs to perform the reproduction. So these are called as the reproductive organs. And these organs combinedly helps in the reproduction, that is called as the reproductive system. That is called as the reproductive system. In the previous classes, I have told you that is repeatedly that, that is the what is organ and what is the system. That is the systems, that is where different organs combinedly or togetherly perform a common function is called as the system. So that is the human beings or any organism, that is, it is formed by the combination of a different system, digestive system, circulatory system, respiratory system, as well as the reproductive system. In the reproductive system, that is, it comprises of many reproductive organs. The male contains the male reproductive organ, and the female contains the female reproductive organ. And these organs are called as the reproductive organs, and they are classified into two groups. One is the primary, or that is called as the essential reproductive organs. The reproductive organs. Reproductive organs. These reproductive organs are differentiated into two categories. One is the primary or accessory reproductive organs. Another is the secondary that is reproductive organ. Primary reproductive organ or essential reproductive organ, and the secondary or accessory reproductive organ. These are the essential. It is the accessory reproductive organs. So these are the primary or essential reproductive organ. This is secondary or that is accessory reproductive organ. So what is the difference between the primary or essential reproductive organ and secondary or that is the accessory reproductive organ? The primary reproductive organ are the main reproductive organ where the primary, that is the primary or essential reproductive organs are the organs where the gametes are formed and the sex hormones are secreted. They are called as the primary, that is reproductive organ, where the gametes are formed and the sex hormones are formed. The sex hormones in case of the man, it is called as the testosterone, and in case of the female, it is called as the estrogen, progesterone, etc. The secondary, and these are the nothing but the testes and ovary. These are nothing but the testes in case of the male, and in case of the female, it is called as the ovary. These are the primary or essential reproductive organ. But in secondary, or that is the accessory reproductive organs, that is, are the organs which helps in the reproduction, but they do not produce directly the gametes or the sex hormones or the sex hormones, but they are necessary for the reproduction, as that is the gametes travels through these paths and they help in the copulation, as well as they provide the space for the development, etc. And they are also secreting some essential substances, but not the hormones, but not the sex hormones. So these are the secondary reproductive organs, like that is the penis, vagina in case of the female, and the spermatic duct in case of the male, and oviduct in case of the female, and etc. So these are the secondary, that is the reproductive organ, and this is the primary reproductive organ. Besides the reproductive organs, another thing is that is called as the secondary sexual character. The secondary sexual character and this secondary sexual character are very important character which develops towards the puberty. Puberty means that is the date or the time where the male or the female that is get maturity or get mature. That means their reproductive organs starts functioning. That time is called as the puberty. The time from where the one individual, either the male or the female, gets maturity or becomes matured at that time is, at that point is called as the puberty. And when the individual lost it, that is the reproductive phase is lost by the individual, that is called as the menopause. In case of female, it is called as the menopause. But in case of the male, that proceeds towards the last end of the life. So in case of the male, generally there is no menopause. But so anyway, that is secondary reproductive organ, secondary reproductive characters are the characters which appears externally towards the puberty or in the puberty, where it distinguishes a male from a female or a female from a male. What are these? So what are the example? In case of the male, that is the development of the, that is the Adam's apple, but tonsil. That not tonsil, that is the Adam's apple. That is the voice becomes loud or voice becomes grave. That is the change of the voice occurs in case of the male. Another, that is the development of the hairs on the face, that is mustard and beards, etc. And the development of pubic hair and the development of axial hair. In case of the female, that is the development of mammary gland and the development of fat below the skin and the widening of the pelvic region and the development of, that is the axial hair as well as the pubic hair, are the main secondary sexual character which distinguish or which separate a male from a female. And above all, another thing, they becomes, or the male, that is in this respect and in this time, that is the male is attracted towards the, or that is the attracted towards the female, and also the female is attracted towards the male. That is the sexual urge develops during, that is in this period. So these are the, that is the secondary sexual character. So you have to remember three things. One is the primary sex organ. Another is the secondary sex. Primary sex organ are the essential sex organ without which, that is, the reproduction cannot occur. And the secondary sex organ, that is, they helping in the reproduction, but they are not the primary sex organ, as because they are not producing the sperm and ovum and they are not secreting the sex hormone. And the third thing is, that is the thing, that is the secondary sexual character. That is that character which generally develops towards the puberty or after puberty, and that is the which distinguishes a male from a female and a female from the male by certain external characteristics like the development of a mustard, beard, and the change of a tone in case of the male and the enlargement of a penis. But in case of female, it is the breast, development of a breast, axial hair, pubic hair, not the hair on the face. So